Major funding for KidVision Mission is brought to you in part by
the Children's Services Council of Broward County supports KidVision and public television. We are dedicated to enriching children's lives and empowering them to become responsible and productive adults.
It's time for a field trip.
KidVision Kids, I'm arranging my flowers. They're so beautiful. They smell good too. Would you want to smell? Use your nose. Good job. I love flowers. They use a lot of our senses, flowers do. Do you know that we have 5 senses? And it tells us all about the world. And they're mostly on our face. We smell with our nose. We see with our eyes. We hear with our ears. We taste with our mouth. And we feel with our hands. It's that easy. And we use our senses all the time. Oh, I have something else that is like a flower. Broccoli. Did you know that broccoli is a flower? It is. And we're going to use broccoli to explore our 5 senses. First, I'm going to feel it. It's hard, and it's a little bit slimy because it's cold and wet. Should we smell it? It smells like broccoli. Here, smell. That's it. And let's use our eyes. What color is broccoli?
Green!
That's right, it's green. Let's hear the broccoli. I'm going to pull off a piece of flower. A little bit hard, it's stuck in here. Let's see. Listen. Did you hear it come off?
Yes!
I heard it. And now we're gonna taste it. Do you like broccoli?
Yes!
Let's taste it. Okay. We're getting a KidVision mission file. Let's see what it is. Wow, that's Miss Alexa. That means we're going on a nature walk. Are you ready for a KidVision mission?
Alexa, and this is my friend Fred. And today we're going to do nature class, and we have a very special guest. We have Miss Penny here with us.
Hello.
Can you say hi, Miss Penny?
Hi, Miss Penny.
Hi, Miss Penny. And hello, friends. Hi. Today we're going to talk about our senses. Do you know what our senses are?
Yeah.
Our senses is how we get information from the environment. We can use the sense of sight. Go like this, open and close. Your eyes, we use our eyes to see things. Go like this. We use our nose to smell. Go like this. What do you hear? I hear a woodpecker. We use our ears to listen. Go like this. We use our tongue to taste. And what's this? Pickle, pickle, pickle. Wiggly fingers. We use our hands to?
Touch.
Good job. Everybody close your eyes and hold out your hand. Take out your hand. And I'm gonna give you something for you to touch. No peeking. Open your eyes. Did you know? It's a lemon. Okay. Scratch it like this. Scratch it with your nail. Okay? And go like this. Smell sour, like sour, because you know that lemons are sour. Yeah? Let's put my box behind. I'm gonna give you a trick. You making sounds?
Yes.
Let me hear it. Oh, good job, I do hear. Look what I'm going to do. What do you see?
Seeds!
Seeds! Did you taste it? Get your tongue out! And now flip your lemon like this. Ooh, that's sour! So today, we're gonna go on a nature walk and we're going to see what we find. Let's try not to eat anything that we find because sometimes we don't know if it's poisonous. So before you touch something, please ask Miss Alexa, okay? And we'll observe together around the lake and things we find. We're going to do some observations. You know what observation means? It means we are going to look with our eyes, and we are going to ask questions, and we are going to use our nature tools to see what things are.
You ready for a nature walk?
Yeah! Let's go!
This is the first spot that we get to observe and use our senses to see what we can find.
Miss Penny, look what you have behind you.
Bones.
Oh my goodness. Great observation, Manu. Those are bones. KidVision Kids, we found something. But before we're going to do some observation, we need to keep it safe. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit of the rules that we have for today. So we don't touch anything with our hands. I have tools. So the first thing that we're going to do is I'm gonna give you some magnifying glasses so that we can observe what we find.
You see bones?
You see bones. What color do you see are these bones?
White.
White. Who lives in this lake that could have bones?
Dogs.
Wow, KidVision Kids, look what I found on the nature walk. What do you think you could find on a nature walk? Oh, hi, Shiny. Did you find something cool on the nature walk? Wow, that's an awesome leaf, Shiny. What else can we find on a nature walk?
It's a coconut. Do we make sounds? Yeah, it makes a sound when we tap it. Yeah. The sense of smell. Let's smell it. Coconut. The sense of taste. No, just kidding. We're not gonna take it.
There's coconut juice that we could.
That is true. Before it stems out, we can drink the coconut juice. That's a great observation, Miss Penny. Good job. Then the sense of sight. Look at the stem is growing out and the roots. It is rooting. This is gonna turn into a very big coconut tree. Hey, KidVision Kids, we finished our nature walk and we saw so many good things. Now it is time to do our nature poem. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes. This poem says, today I went on a nature walk. I saw with my eyes. I heard with my ears. I smelled with my nose. I touched with my hands. Today I went on a nature walk. Okay. Today, I went on a nature walk. I saw, what did we see?
Bones.
I'm gonna write bones. I heard, what did we hear?
A windy.
The wind, when the trees were moving.
Good job.
The wind. I smelled, do we remember what we smelled?
Lemon.
We smelled the lemon, you're right, you're holding the lemon. I touch, what did we touch?
A coconut. coconut.
A coconut.
Cocoa.
Let's read our poem. Today I went on a nature walk. I saw bones. I heard the wind. I smelled the lemon. I touched the coconut. Today I went on a nature walk.
We learned about our senses. Thank you so much for inviting me along.
You're always welcome here, Miss Penny. Bye!
Hi, KidVision Kids, it's Miss Penny. Put on your thinking caps. It's time to learn some new words.
Observation. Observation is an action word. It is when you are actively watching and listening carefully to find out about something or someone. You make observations to learn.
What was that word?
Observation.
Good job.
Nature walk. A nature walk is about observing the environment with your senses. All you need is somewhere to walk. Then explore the environment using your senses and your motor skills.
What was that word?
Nature walk.
Good job.
The five senses. Most people have five senses: seeing, hearing, touching, smelling, and tasting. These senses help us learn about the world around us.
What was that word?
Five senses.
Good job.
Lake. A lake is a large body of water that is surrounded by land. It is larger than a pond, but smaller than an ocean. Most lakes are freshwater.
What was that word?
Lake.
Good job. KidVision Kids, I loved going on that nature walk. We learned all about the five senses. Do you remember what they are?
Yes.
They are, we see with our eyes, we smell with our nose, we taste with our mouth, we feel with our hands, and we hear with our ears. Do you hear something? I hear a bee. Maybe because the flowers are here and bees love flowers. Let's see if we can find it. Where is the bee? Where could it be? Bee, I hear the buzzing. Where could it be?
Shiny. Shiny.
Shiny? I don't see a bee, but I see shiny. Are you scared? Sometimes we feel scared. Do you ever feel scared?
Yes.
Sometimes if we feel scared, it's because we don't know about things. I think it's time for a KidVision mission. Let's find out about bees and then we'll feel less scared about them. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's go.
Hi, I'm Kim, the bee lady. I'm a beekeeper, and I'm super excited to teach you all about the bees and how they make honey.
We're excited too. Are you excited?
Yeah!
Are you ready to learn about bees and how to make honey? Yeah, me too. Let's go.
The honeybee having three separate segmented body parts along with six legs is what makes it an insect. The antennae are used to feel, as well as kind of like a nose with olfactory glands to smell. Bees have two separate types of eyes, three ocelli and two compound eyes. These different eyes can look in all different directions so the bees can see really far to see where those delicious flowers are located.
Look at that. What is that long thing down there?
This is the proboscis. This is basically the tongue of the bee. So we can stick it way down inside the flower cups to get the nectar out. The thorax is where the wings are located. They beat their wings 190 times a second. On the next segment, the abdomen is where the body portion that houses all of their organs are. They have two separate stomachs. One is a digestion stomach like we have,
like
where we get our
stomach?
Food.
Where's
but the
stomach?
Other one is a honey stomach. And they only put the nectar that's collected into that honey stomach so it can be mixed with enzymes to create that delicious honey that we all love. Over here, they have a pollen basket. They can fly really far with big bags of pollen on it. Now, also on the abdomen is where they have the stinger sac, the thing that everybody fears about bees. But bees will only use the stinger sac when they are threatened. The coolest thing about the bee's abdomen is that they use their abdomen to make this crazy dance called the bee dance. By shaking their abdomen all around is how they're able to communicate to all the other bees where to find the delicious flowers.
Miss Kim is a beekeeper, so she's gonna show us what beekeepers wear and the tools that they use to take care of the bees. Now we have a beekeeper with us, Miss Kim, and she is going to tell us all about the materials and equipment that beekeepers need and what they need to wear.
This is a bee box. This is where the bees live inside once they rescue them and bring them home. The bees will actually build their homes onto this. So to be able to get inside here, you have to use a hive tool. When you go to pull out a frame, there's always gonna be bees on it. So you'll use this small little wire brush to brush the bees down. We also have other tools like this. This is a queen clip. So what you'll see right here, here's a picture of a queen. Now see how much different she looks than the other bees? See how long the back of her body is?
She's the only one that lays eggs.
Correct.
And how many eggs does she lay?
She can lay up to 2,000 eggs a day.
So she's all of their mom.
Correct. Another tool that we use is the smoker. You would fill it with pine needles and then light it with a lighter. And when the smoke comes, it disguises our smell so the bees don't realize that we're not from there, so they don't get too defensive when we come in.
Now, Miss Kim, let's learn about the beekeeper's outfit.
So here's the bee suit. This is a full body suit with a hood. Hold it. It's kind of heavy, huh? So I'm gonna go ahead and put it on so you guys can see. And then you have the glove. But this extra layer here, because your arms are mostly what's inside when you're working with the bees.
We're almost ready to see the bees. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Are you sure?
Yeah!
All right.
I'm ready, thank you, Miss Kim.
Of course.
We're talking about honeycombs, and they're very important to the bees.
They build the actual hexagon combs. They store food, they nurture the queen. They fill those combs with either bee bread, pollen, nectar, honey, or the queen lays eggs in there, and then those hatch into babies.
How many sides does it have if it's
six,
a hexagon?
Six.
One, two, three, four, five, six. So we're gonna draw a hexagon and turn it into a honeycomb. Let's make a roof for the top of the honeycomb. Now make a V at the bottom, not touching. Now we're gonna connect the roof and the V with lines on both sides. Boom, you've got it. So that's one honeycomb. Let's make more because look, they're all connected. Do you wanna see a real honeycomb?
Yeah!
I think we can do that.
All right.
Wow.
What do you see?
I can see the bees.
Can you hear them? What makes that sound? How do they make that sound? With their wings. I see bees flying around. They see the light coming through. I see sealed honey up here in the top. See how it's capped over? See how these little middle ones look like different color than those? Those are the brood. That's where the babies are stored. And then when they're ready, they're gonna hatch out.
Keep looking, I can see all the hexagons and some of them are filled with honey.
How about if we take some frames and extract the honey?
That would be really exciting.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
All right.
Okay, good, thank you. Now we're about to learn about honey.
So, after all those days of flying miles and miles and visiting hundreds of flowers every day, they brought back the nectar. They made the wax coating with their body, and they covered it. And now, it's ready for us to extract it. Well, what we first have to do is we have to get the honey, the frame from the hive. Now we see how all the caps are wax coated over here?
Yes.
So we use this little nifty tool. We're gonna scrape away all this honey. So now that the wax cap is scraped off, we're gonna bring it down here into the centrifuge extractor. So now how this works is we have two of those frames inside of here. And if you could help us first by spinning. Who's ready to see it come out?
Me.
One of the world's strongest antibiotics.
Look at that.
Here we have some natural honeycombs that we extracted from a bee removal. So inside here, as we break it open and crush it, the honey is just going to squeeze out.
Goodness.
And come out like this.
Thank you so much, Bee Lady.
Thank you for having me. I had a great time with you guys. And from all your hard work and learning, we're gonna take home the honey today.
Woo!
That we extracted from the hive so you can enjoy it with your family.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye. Be good. Hi, KidVision Kids, it's Miss Penny. Put on your thinking caps. It's time to learn some new words.
Beekeeper. A beekeeper is a person who keeps and cares for honeybees.
What was that word?
Beekeeper.
Good job.
Honey. Honey is a sweet, sticky, golden brown fluid made by bees from the nectar of flowers.
What was that word?
Honey.
Good job.
Honeybee. A honeybee is a flying insect known for making honey.
What was that word?
Honey.
Good job.
Honeycomb. A honeycomb is a structure of hexagon-shaped wax cells that store honey.
What was that word?
Honeycomb.
Good job. The Bee Lady was amazing. She showed us how the bees use their five senses. They have antenna. On their antenna, they smell and they feel. They have five eyes. So when they look around, they move their eyeballs everywhere. Can you move your eyeballs all around? Good job. They taste with their very long tongue. And they hear with their legs. Amazing! All right, we're gonna do a bee dance, and it's gonna start by waggling. Waggle, 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 flap those wings. Waggle, 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 and here we go. Waggle like a bee, waggle like a bee. When I count to three, smell and touch like a bee. One, two, three. Good job! What's next? Waggle like a bee, waggle like a bee. When I count to three, see like a bee. One, two, three. Good job! Waggle like a bee, waggle like a bee. When I count to three, hear like a bee. One, two, three. Good job! Woo! Waggle like a bee, waggle like a bee. When I count to three, sound like a bee. One, two, three. Good job! KidVision Kids, you did a great job learning all about the five senses. When I count to three, we're going to say mission accomplished together. Are you ready? One, two, three.
Mission accomplished!
Good job. See you next time.
We're on a KidVision mission. With Miss Penny, a KidVision mission. And Shiny too, helping presents what they do. We're on a KidVision mission with you. So much to learn, so much to see. KidVision Kids, come along with me. Miss Penny and Shiny gonna lead the way. Adventure on, we'll save the day. We're on a KidVision mission. With Miss Penny, a KidVision mission. And Shiny too, helping presents what they do.
Major funding for KidVision Mission is brought to you in part by
the Children's Services Council of Broward County supports KidVision and public television. We are dedicated to enriching children's lives and empowering them to become responsible and productive adults.